Hi, welcome to the second episode of Some Good News. I'm Emily Traeger, reporting to you live again from my dining room. For our first story this week, we're going to head over to Longacre Elementary School, where the principal continues to do daily announcements. Every Tuesday, she offers a thoughtful challenge for her students. For this challenge, Longacre students wrote cards and letters to the Farmington Hills Beaumont Hospital healthcare workers, expressing their support during the pandemic. The kids received a heartfelt thank you from the hospital's chief officer. The project offered an opportunity for the students to do something within their circle of control to brighten the exhausting days of healthcare workers. Additionally, the LOC Federal Credit Union paired with East Middle School to create East Middle School's Credit Union class. Last week, the students participated in a virtual financial reality fair. Students were asked to choose a job with a monthly salary. They had to budget for housing, furniture, food, transportation, and other needs and wants, such as cell phones. This interactive reality fair exposed students to the real-life experience of struggling to afford all desired expenditures and forces them to make some spending decisions on their own. Kirsten Podwowski, a 7th grader at East Middle School, stated, "When we did the simulation, I thought it was cool. I enjoyed seeing what it's like to be an adult and having to spend my money wisely. I did go over budget and had to fix it or I would have lost my home in the real world. I like shopping and I like to spend money, but as an adult, I have to save my money. I enjoyed seeing my finances and what I had to pay for food and other things each month. In conclusion, I liked the reality fair and seeing what it was like to be an adult in a 13-year-old body." District-wide, our Nutrition Services Department, overseen by Angela Davis, has served more than 110,000 meals since the beginning of the pandemic. The meals are for community members who are 18 and under and those who are 26 and under with a disability. Through a partnership with the USDA, we are now able to offer boxes of fruits and vegetables to anyone in the community who would like them. These boxes will be distributed during the same time as the meals every Wednesday from 11 a.m. to 1 p.m. at East Middle School and at North Farmington High School. There's no need to sign up for these boxes either. Continued thank yous go out to our nutrition staff and volunteers who make this happen each week for our families. Laura Koraluski, a kindergarten teacher at Wood Creek Elementary, was inspired by the yard signs she saw for students in her neighborhood and took the idea to staff about making them for Wood Creek students. The staff loved the idea and the yard signs were created with the help of a former parent and money donations from teachers and PTA. Teachers and other staff members delivered the signs personally to each of their students. The looks on the kids' faces were the best. Kids cried, parents were touched, and all from 6 to 8 feet away. Teachers continue to receive emails, texts, and posts on Facebook about how touched they are and how extremely loved their children feel. It took each teacher about 3 hours to deliver, and it was so worth it. This was the highlight of their school year. Lastly, each evening after work in school, the Haar family gathers around their dining room table, which they have now converted into a mask-making workshop, and work until it is time for bed. They started receiving donations of fabrics, t-shirts, and money towards supplies and quickly crossed the 300 mask mark. Since that time, their story has been picked up by WWJ News Radio, USA Today's Hometown Life, WDIV, and one family member appeared on State Representative candidate Samantha Stelkoff's Sunday Ask Me Anything Zoom chat. They have now made more than 2,500 masks. These masks have gone to doctors' offices, COVID-19 testing laboratories, veterinary clinics, senior living communities, Meals on Wheels drivers, and even the Sterling Heights post offices. Keep it up, Haar family. That'll wrap it up for this week's episode of Some Good News. And once again, if you see something, say something. Please leave more amazing stories from our community on our Google form by clicking the link in the description below. That's it for me, and we'll see you guys next week on Some Good News, Farmington Edition.